Now, let's illustrate Diffie-Hellman key exchange algorithm using an example. The prime number, q, is 353, and the alpha, which is the primitive root of q, is 3. User A selects a random number, which is a secret to herself, and this value is 97. So she computes YA, which is 3 raised to the power of 97 mod 353, and the result is 40. User B selects a random number, which is a secret to himself, and this value is 233. And he computes YB, which is 3 raised to the power of 233 mod 353, and the result is 248. And they exchange these values, that is, user A sends 40 to user B, and user B sends 248 to user A. Then user A computes the following: YA raised to the power of XA mod Q. In this case, will be 248 raised to the power of 97 mod 353. And the result is 160. Likewise, user B computes YA raised to the power of XB mod Q. In this case, it is 40 raised to the power of 233 mod 353. And the result is 160. So as you can see, by exchanging YA and YB, both users A and B compute the same secret value, which is 160. And this would become the shared secret key between users A and B. We assume that an attacker will be able to obtain these publicly exchanged values, which we call them public keys, and they also know the publicly known numbers, Q and alpha. In this case, because the integers involved are very small, it is feasible that the attacker will be able to figure out the secret value XA and XB, which is 97 and 233. However, if very large number is involved, such as when the prime number Q is at least 300 bits long, then the task of finding XA, the secret value, from YA, the public value, is not feasible.